Hello guys, myself Ajinkya. How are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So today I am going to explain you class 7th English lesson, that is lumber room. To understand the lesson clearly, please watch the video till end. So let's start. Before understanding the lesson, we must know what is mean by lumber room. Lumber room is a place where unwanted and unimportant things are kept. So let's start. The children were to be driven as a special train to the sands at Jagburu. Means the children were taken as a special train to the sands at Jagburu, which means the Jagburu beach. Nicholas was not allowed as he was in disgrace. Means Nicholas was not allowed to go to Jagburu as he has done a bad thing. Disgrace means a bad thing or a bad habit. Only that morning, he had refused to eat his wholesome bread and milk on the grounds that there was frog in it. Older, wiser and better people had told him that he was not to talk nonsense. The dramatic part of the incident was that there really was a frog in Nicholas' basin of bread and milk. He had put it there himself and proved the older, wiser and better people wrong. So here the reason is given why was Nicholas in disgrace. That morning Nicholas refused to eat his breakfast, which consists of bread and milk. He was telling that in his breakfast there was frog. Older, wiser and better people were telling that don't talk nonsense. But the dramatic part of the incident was that there really was a frog in his breakfast. And he put that frog there himself to prove the older, wiser and better people wrong. So the aunt hastily invented the Jagburu trip. Means the aunt fastly invented means planned the Jagburu trip. Whenever one of the children fell from grace, the aunt planned something of a festive nature for the children from which the offender would be debarred. Means whenever one of the children becomes naughty and he doesn't follow rules, then his aunt plans a picnic or a festive nature for which the children who has not followed rules would be not allowed to be participate. After the children left for Jagburu, the aunt told Nicholas that he should not go into the gooseberry garden. Means that he should not go into gooseberry garden. Why not? Demanded Nicholas. Now Nicholas is demanding that why he cannot go to gooseberry garden. So the aunt replies that because you are in disgrace, means you have done the bad thing. You have done a bad thing, so you cannot go to gooseberry garden. The aunt said in a superior manner. Loftily means in a superior manner. Nicholas' face took an expression of considerable obstinacy. Obstinacy means refusing something to do. After listening to his aunt's reply, then Nicholas, he became sad. It was clear to his aunt that he was determined to get into the gooseberry garden only because she had told him not to. Means that his aunt was knowing that he would enter gooseberry garden because she told him that he should not enter. In the afternoon, the aunt spent an hour or two in the trivial gardening operations from where she could watch the doors that led to the forbidden area. Means that afternoon, aunt spent 1 or 2 hours in the trivial gardening operations, means unimportant gardening operations, from where she could watch the doors that led to the forbidden area, means the gooseberry garden. Nicholas wriggled his way with obvious stealth of purpose towards one of the doors. Means he carefully went, secretly moved towards one of the doors. In fact, he did not want to get into the gooseberry garden, but he wanted his aunt to believe that he had been to gooseberry garden in order to keep her on self-imposed sentry duty. Means he was secretly moving and he did not wanted to get into Gooseberry Garden, but he wanted his aunt to believe that he wanted to go to Gooseberry Garden, but his actual plan was to discover the secrets of the lumber room. Having thoroughly confirmed her suspicions, Nicholas slipped back into the house. When Nicholas understood that what his aunt wanted to do, then Nicholas went back into the house and he went into the library. By standing on the chair in the library, he reached the shelf on which lay a fat, important-looking key. The key was an instrument which kept the mysteries of the lumber room secured from unauthorized intrusion. Means he entered the library of his house, and by climbing on a chair, he reached the shelf on which lay a fat, means on that there was a key of the lumber room, and the key was the instrument through which he can open the lumber room. Nicholas opened the door of the lumber room, and inside he saw interesting objects like a tapestry picture depicting the story of a man hunting a stag, quaint twisted candlesticks in the shape of snakes, a teapot fashioned like a china duck, a carved sandalwood box packed with aromatic cotton wool and brass figures of humpbacked bulls and peacocks and goblins. When Nicholas opened the door with the help of the key that he found, he entered inside, and inside he saw many interesting objects like tapestry picture that depicting the story of a man hunting a stag, which means the male deer, quaint twisted candlesticks in the shape of snakes. Quaint means old-fashioned twisted candlesticks which were in the shape of snakes, a teapot fashioned like a china duck, a carved sandalwood box packed with aromatic cotton wool and brass figures of humpbacked bulls, peacocks and goblins. Means there also was a carved sandalwood box which were packed with aromatic. Aromatic means having pleasant smell. With aromatic cotton wool and brass figures of humpbacked bulls, peacocks and goblins. Less promising in appearance was a large square book with plain black covers. Nicholas peeped into it, and behold, it was full of colored pictures of birds. Means also there was a large square book which has plain black covers. And Nicholas peeped into it, means he looked that secretly and carefully. And that book was full of colored pictures of birds. As he was admiring the coloring of the mandarin duck, the voice of his aunt calling his name came from the Gooseberry Garden. Means when he was reading the book of the colorful pictures of the birds, and when he opened the picture of mandarin duck, the voice of his aunt calling his name came from the Gooseberry Garden. Nicholas, you are to come out of at this once. It's no use to trying to hide there. I can see you all the time. Means she was screaming Nicholas and telling him to come out. She was acting as just she knew that where is Nicholas, but actually she didn't know where is Nicholas. She wanted to know where is Nicholas. So she was screaming. Presently, the angry repetitions of Nicholas' name gave way to a cry for help. Nicholas shut down the book and restored it carefully to its place in the corner. Once Nicholas shut down the book and restored means keep it again properly to its place in the corner. Then he crept from the room, locked the door and replaced the key exactly where he had found it. Then crept means moving very slowly. He moved very slowly from the room. He locked the door with the key and he replaced the key exactly where he had found it. His aunt was still calling his name when he sauntered into the front garden. Sauntered means walking in a relaxed manner. His aunt was calling to Nicholas many times, so Nicholas sauntered into the front garden, means he walked in a relaxed manner and he went into the front garden. Now when he reached into the front garden, gooseberry garden, he asked, "Who is calling?" "Me," came the answer from the other side of the wall. "Didn't you hear me? I have been looking for you in the gooseberry garden and I have slipped into the rainwater tank. Luckily, there is no water in it, but the sides of the tank are slippery and I can't get out. Fetch the little ladder from under the cherry tree." When Nicholas asked, "Who is calling?" then "Me," came the answer from the other side of the wall, means from the rainwater tank. "Someone called me." "Me" means inside the rainwater tank there was his aunt, and she was finding for Nicholas in the gooseberry garden. But while searching for Nicholas, she slipped into the rainwater tank. But luckily there was no water in it and the sides of the wall were slippery and now she can't get out. So she wanted Nicholas to give her the ladder from under the cherry tree. Now Nicholas is telling, "I was told I wasn't to go into the gooseberry garden," said Nicholas promptly, means immediately without delay. Means now Nicholas is telling that you only told me that I can't enter the gooseberry garden. So how can I enter now? Now aunt is replying that, "I told you not to and now I tell you that you may," came the voice from the rainwater tank rather impatiently. Means now aunt is telling that, "Before I told you that you can't enter, now I am telling that you may enter." And she told that without patience. "Your voice doesn't sound like aunt's," objected Nicholas. "You may be someone who is attempting me to be disobedient." Now Nicholas is knowing that there is aunt inside the rainwater tank, but he was acting as just he was talking to someone who is trying to mislead him into entering the forbidden gooseberry garden. Means that he is angry on his aunt and she didn't allow him, Nicholas, to go to the gooseberry garden. So to make fun of his aunt, he is telling that. "Don't talk nonsense," said the prisoner in the tank. "Go and fetch ladder." Means now aunt is telling that, "Don't talk nonsense and go and give me the ladder." Now Nicholas is telling, will be strawberry jam for tea?" asked Nicholas innocently, means without no emotions. Then, "Certainly there will be," said the aunt, privately resolving that Nicholas should have none of it. "Certainly there will be" means without doubt. "There will be. I will surely give you," said the aunt. And privately resolving means privately deciding. She was privately deciding that Nicholas should not get any of it. "Now I know that you are not the aunt," shouted Nicholas gleefully. "When we asked aunt for strawberry jam yesterday, she said that there wasn't any. I know there are 4 jars of it in the store cupboard because I looked, and of course you know it's there." Now Nicholas says that, "Now I know that you are not the aunt," he is shouting happily. "When we asked aunt for strawberry jam yesterday, she said that there wasn't any." And he searched in the house and he came to know about that in the store cupboard there are 4 jars of it. And aunt is also knowing that. And it was the kitchen maid who eventually rescued the aunt from the rainwater tank. Tea that evening was partaken of in a fearsome silence. Means the tea that evening was partaken. Partaken means to eat or drink. Or in a fearsome silence, means very silently. The tide had been at its highest when the children had arrived at the Jagborough Cove. Means when the children arrived at the Jagborough beach, the tide of the sea was at its highest. एंड सो दे कुड नॉट प्ले ऑन द सैंड्स मीन्स ऑन द बीच बिकॉज देर वॉज वॉटर ऑन इट सो हाउ दे कैन प्ले एंड दिस वॉज द सर्कमस्टेंस दैट द आंट हैड ओवरलुक्ड इन द हास्ट ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग द एक्सपीडिशन द आंट मेंटेन्ड फ्रोजन म्यूटनेस ऑफ वन हु हैज सफर्ड अनडिग्निफाइड एंड अनमेरिटेड डिटेंशन इन द रेन वॉटर टैंक फॉर 35 minutes फ्रोजन म्यूटनेस मीन्स कंप्लीटली साइलेंस अनडिग्निफाइड मीन्स नो रिस्पेक्ट एंड अनमेरिटेड डिटेंशन मीन लूजिंग रिस्पेक्ट दिस लाइन मीन्स दैट एज शी वॉज इम्प्रिजेंट इन द रेन वॉटर टैंक फॉर 35 minutes She got no respect and she was disrespectfully imprisoned in the tank. And also she was feeling shy because no one helped her when she was in the rainwater tank. As for Nicholas, he too was silent in the absorption of one who has much to think about. So this is how I explained this lesson. Now I am going to discuss with you the question and answers of the lesson, The Lumber Room. Why was Nicholas in disgrace? Nicholas was in disgrace because he had refused to eat his wholesome bread and milk on the grounds that there was frog in it. What was the punishment given by his aunt? Nicholas was not allowed to go to the sands at Jackborough where the other children were going as a special treat. Why did Nicholas want his aunt to think that he had got into the gooseberry garden? Nicholas wanted his aunt to think that he had got into the gooseberry garden because he wanted to go to the lumber room. Find a word from the extract which means the same as healthy and nutritious. Wholesome. What was the forbidden area? The gooseberry garden was the forbidden area. How did the aunt spend her time in the afternoon? In the afternoon, the aunt spent an hour or two in the trivial gardening operations from where she could watch the doors that led to the forbidden area. How did the frog came into Nicholas' basin of milk and bread? There was a frog in Nicholas' basin of milk and bread as he had put it there himself to prove the older, wiser and better people wrong. Find a word from the extract which means the same as careful movement. Stealth. Why did the aunt guarded the entrance of the gooseberry garden that afternoon? The aunt knew that Nicholas would go to the gooseberry garden because she had told him that he is not to. Hence, she spent time guarding the entrance of the gooseberry garden because she did not want him to enjoy his detention time in the gooseberry garden. What did Nicholas found in the lumber room? Inside the lumber room, Nicholas found an interesting tapestry picture. Candlesticks in the shape of snakes, a teapot fashioned like a china duck, a carved sandalwood box packed with aromatic cotton wool and brass figures of humped-necked bulls, peacocks and goblins, and a large square box of colored pictures of birds. How did Nicholas mislead his aunt in order to carry out his plan to enter the lumber room? Nicholas made frequent trips into the front garden to mislead his aunt and make her believe that he wanted to enter the gooseberry garden. Whereas his actual plan was to discover the secrets of the lumber room. Why did the aunt call out to Nicholas for help? The aunt called out to Nicholas for help because she had slipped into the rainwater tank and wasn't able to get out. She wanted Nicholas to bring the little ladder from under the cherry tree. Answer in 80 to 100 words. Why were the rest of the children given a special treat? Whenever a child was under a punishment, the aunt used to organize picnics or something of a festive nature in which the offender was not allowed to participate. The aunt decided to send the other three children to Jackborough as she wanted to punish Nicholas for his disgraceful behavior at the breakfast table when he had brought a frog and put it in his breakfast of bread and milk. Thus, the offender was made to feel sorry for his mistake. In this case, to punish Nicholas, she was sending rest of the children to Jackborough. How did Nicholas spend his time in the lumber room? First, Nicholas misled his aunt in order to make her believe that he wanted to enter the gooseberry garden, whereas his actual plan was to discover the secrets of the lumber room. Nicholas was fascinated with the exhibits of the lumber room, as it was forbidden delight for him. Then his aunt fell into the rainwater tank. Though he knew that it was his aunt, he acted as if he was talking to someone who was trying to mislead him into entering the forbidden gooseberry garden. Thus, it was a fun-filled day for him. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Have a nice day ahead. Thank you.